We start on the ventral surface of the human brain by slicing it coronally. An approximately 3 centimeter thick segment has been sliced coronally from the temporal pole. I am now moving into the more rostral slices, going caudally. We will delve into them on an as-needed basis for specifically identifying basal ganglia-related components. Here's a coronal slice taken at the mammillary level. These are the mammillary bodies for our reference. First, we are identifying telencephalic and then diencephalic components. First, for the neostriatum or dorsal striatum, the caudate and the putamen. For the pallidum, globus pallidus. Specifically, the external and the internal divisions or segments of globus pallidus. In addition, providing inputs to the striatum, just generally speaking, a broad area of cerebral cortex is recruited. For the outputs of basal ganglia via the pallidum, these will go to certain thalamic nuclei. For example, in this section, the VL or ventrolateral nucleus of thalamus can be identified. While we are in this section, at the mammillary body level or behind, the subthalamic nucleus needs to be recognized, as I'm outlining now. This is one of the intrinsic components in basal ganglia-related neurocircuitry. The next two slices will take us much more rostral in the forebrain to compare and contrast the dorsal and ventral basal ganglia. Keep in mind that the dorsal and ventral components of basal ganglia are anatomically and functionally distinct. Moving into these rostral slices, we will still first identify the dorsal components before the ventral ones. The caudate and the putamen, the caudate and the putamen on the side. Moving to the other section, again caudate and putamen, the other side, caudate and putamen. These represent dorsal striatum. For the ventral striatum, we move to this slice only. This is the only level where nucleus accumbens can be identified here. Part of ventral striatum. For the ventral pallidum, we move to this section identified here, ventrally, just lateral to preoptic area of hypothalamus as we move into ventral pallidum or substantia innominata. The regular globus pallidus is here. It is still part of dorsal pallidum. Our journey regarding basal ganglia and related components now takes us to the midbrain. Here's a mid-rostral midbrain in front of us in cross-section. And near the peduncular region, here is substantia nigra, the compact zone, identified by these pigmented neurons. These neurons send dopaminergic projections to the previously covered dorsal striatum, the caudate, and putamen. Immediately adjacent to the compact zone, ventral to it, here is the reticular zone, also in substantia nigra. These are GABAergic neurons that are thought to be an extension of pallidum, reminding us of the previously mentioned globus pallidus. In addition, there is a more medially located area also producing dopamine, but these are typically not pigmented neurons. This is the VTA, or ventral tegmental area. The VTA sends dopaminergic projections to the ventral striatum, which is the previously identified nucleus accumbens. And in addition to nucleus accumbens, the VTA also sends dopamine projections to prefrontal cortex. Therefore, by the identification of substantia nigra, compact zone, substantia nigra, reticular zone, and the ventral tegmental area, our survey of basal ganglia-related components is now complete.